Colleagues, we have before us a bill. We heard about the two different parts of it before. We already argued that. However, I'm here in opposition of House Bill 55, not because I disagree with equal protection under the law for race and ethnicity. I believe that we should go further with that, and we heard about that yesterday. However, the opposition that I have to House Bill 55 stems from one of the largest businesses within my district. Many of you have come across it. Many of you have probably been to a ball game once and had one of their hot dogs. The Clemens Food Group wrote me a letter today, and I'm going to read that letter to you because I like how one of our members said before that this is not a political issue, and it's not, because they're probably on the other side of I when it comes to politics. But we do agree on one thing, and I'm going to read this letter to you. I am writing to you on behalf, and I quote, on behalf of the Clemens Family Corporation, also known as Clemens to many people, to express our concern regarding and opposition to House Bill 55. Clemens is a sixth-generation family-owned pork processing company that's been operating in Hatfield, Pennsylvania for over 125 years. Clemens employs over 4,000 team members in our facilities and farm operations, with approximately 2,500 team members employed at our corporate headquarters in Hatfield, Montgomery County. In addition to our corporate headquarters in Hatfield, we operate a separate plant in Emmaus, Lehigh County, and numerous farms across the Commonwealth. We produce, and this is their words, delicious and wholesome pork products under our Hatfield Quality Meats brand. Clemens is one of the largest food production companies in Pennsylvania and the United States. Additionally, hundreds, if not thousands, of independent farmers, restaurants, businesses, and grocers depend on Clemens to put food on the table. While we fully support the principles of appropriate checks and balances to prohibit abuses of power for the reasons set forth below, the conversation on changing or limiting the governor's emergency powers should be reserved until this once-in-a-100-year pandemic is safely behind us. The legislative process is critical to ensure fair debate and review of the potential impact of governmental action. However, the legislative process is not well-suited to deal with sudden emergencies like a pandemic. This is precisely the reason why the power to declare emergencies has been traditionally reserved for the executive branch, which is best suited to pivot, coordinate, and redirect government resources. The executive branch must be empowered to make hard but necessary decisions to protect the lives of Pennsylvanians without being subject to the inevitable debate inherent in the legislative assembly process, which has the potential to delay life-saving state intervention during a time of need. Although we may not have personally agreed with some of the emergency orders issued by our governor during the pandemic, we do believe such actions were necessary to protect the health and lives of Pennsylvanians across the Commonwealth. Quick and uniform action in the form of social distancing and partial shutdowns were necessary to limit the spread of COVID-19. While most traditional natural disasters do not last more than 90 days, the current 90-day emergency period allows for the recovery phase to begin without unnecessary delay, limiting the declaration of an emergency to 21 days from the current 90 days, and requiring legislative approval for an extension will delay the deployment of state assistance when time is of the essence, and will unnecessarily risk the health and safety of Pennsylvanians. Accordingly, we believe that limiting or amending the executive branch's emergency powers should be reserved until after the pandemic is safely behind us and with the benefit of hindsight to guide such discussions. We thank you. Signed by their CEO, Doug Clemens, their president, CEO-elect, Craig Edsel, and their senior vice president, president-elect, Bradford Clemens. Mr. Speaker, this particular constitutional amendment within House Bill 55 that we're going to be talking about and voting on very shortly is very troublesome in many ways. And as highlighted by this business, it will affect many of the measures that were put in place in order to continue providing services to our Commonwealth during a time of need and during a very difficult once in 100-year pandemic. Their words. So I ask my colleagues to reconsider what you're thinking of and how you vote on this, and please vote no. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.